Can you hear me?
Yes. Yes.
Shut up.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Well, this is a very special event. It's special for me personally. My relationship with Dr. Perry Sears goes back to before the Zone book. We were making meal plans and working with people and traveling around the country spreading the word on this thing. I met Dr. Sears in 1994, and the Zone book came out in January of 95, is that correct, sir?
Yes, sir.
And it was epic. It was a monumental achievement on a handful of levels. First of all, I'd never seen accuracy and precision applied to intake prescriptions before. And no one else was even really trying. Here's a guy that can tell you, this is how many grams of carbohydrate you need, this is what it would look like, this is how much fat you need, this is what it looked like, and this is how much protein you need. Taught us what it would look like on the plate. So you'd end up after a few weeks of playing this thing, you'd go through a buffet line, and eyeball very close, very accurate and precise prescription for nutrition. Another thing that really stands out with the Zone for me is that prior to Dr. Sears' work, performance nutrition was seen as something very different than nutrition to safeguard your health. And in one fell swoop, we learned that wasn't the case. This thing made a difference in people with coronary heart disease or cancer, because it had a positive impact on their outcome, and this was a way to enhance your performance to win medals. And that too was huge. But I'm not going to say anything more, really. I just want to introduce Dr. Perry Sears.
Well, first of all, I'd like to thank Greg for that very, very kind introduction. And it's been a long time, as he pointed out, nearly 15 years since we first met. And for me, I've been very, very lucky relative to the acceptance of the Zone diet. But again, my kudos go to Greg and the entire CrossFit team for the amazing work they've done in this period of time. And basically look to integrate both innovative training techniques with innovative dietary techniques. And what I'm going to try to do today is basically break this morning into three distinct sections. The first section, talking about Zone wellness and taking wellness to a new level of understanding at the molecular level, at the genetic level. We'll take a 15-minute break after that and then talk about Zone performance, how you can apply these principles to elite athletes to dramatically improve their athletic output. And the final aspect is talking about some of the obstacles that you and your clients will face in terms of reaching peak, not performance, but peak genetic output. And after that, if you're not bored at that point, I'll take questions and answers till the cows come home. So let us start out by talking about Zone wellness. And what exactly is wellness? Well, people don't know, but I think we can define it. Define it as I'll talk about today in terms of inflammation and gene expression. All of a sudden, wellness sounds very high-tech, and it is. In many ways, we've talked about inflammation since the beginning of time, but for the general American public, it became more commonplace with this article in Time magazine about 4 or 5 years ago talking about the secret killer, the surprising link between inflammation, heart disease, cancer, Alzheimer's. Well, if it's such an intimate and secret killer, what is it and how do we get rid of it? There lies the big question of how to achieve wellness and to maintain it. So if this inflammation is so important, why should we be concerned about it? Well, the underlying cause of virtually every chronic disease is increased inflammation. We tend to make medicine a lot more complex than it really is. If you can control inflammation at the molecular level, you have cut the Gordian knot of chronic disease as we know it. It's also the underlying cause of the aging process. That's what makes us age, increased inflammation, which means controlling inflammation will be a lifelong struggle.